What is the pinnacle of murder? That's to let the dead be killed by you willingly. A bizarre murder happened in the small town. A family of four died tragically at home, but the strange thing is the deceased was smiling. Like can't wait to die. Federal agent Will is investigating the true cause of case. He immediately uses his empathy skills, with the rapid back of the camera. The murder scene also gradually being restored. This was supposed to be a normal family dinner. The culprit was sudden visit without invite, but was arranged at the head of the banquet. Will infers the killer first killed three people at the dinner. Finally, shot and killed Mrs. Trent, but soon Will cleared of suspicion of love homicide. Cause based on the info the police have, the Trents are childhood sweethearts, and runs a successful real estate business. Not only successful but also gave birth to three sons, but one son disappeared last year. He was last seen by witnesses getting into an RV, 50% chance of being abducted and other runaway from home. At this time, Will saw the family portrait on the table, but the Trents were smiling very fakely. There is no feeling of happiness in eyes of children. Obviously, this family of four is not as simple as it seems. Then the forensic told her findings. The whole house shows no signs of vandalism, but from the bullet holes in the wall, compared with the wounds of the deceased, the killer shot from the bottom up. He may be sitting or squatting. The police then sent the bullet left by the killer to the lab for comparison. See if they can pick up any clues from past murders. But when viewing the report, Jack found the other three had signs of struggle. But Mrs. Tallon is an exception.
What kind of victim forgives the killer at the moment of death?
A mother.
The next day, police have new clues at the crime scene. They found a pair of six-eye sneakers at the scene. Judging from the degree of pattern wear on the left heel, the killer's feet were of different lengths. Forensic inference: the owner of shoes is most likely a 12-year-old child, because 12-year-old child's body is in the stage of development. Bone growth can lead one leg being longer than other leg, and this most common situation in children during adolescence. Then, the police found seven different protocols at the scene. After sifting out the trans footprints, they found the killer is most likely three teenage child.
Lost boys. I think I've found one of them.
Then Jack found Will, who was investigate the case. It turned out that the forensic matched the identity of suspect based on fingerprint on game console. The suspect's name is Connor. It's a 13-year-old boy. Coincidentally, Connor also disappeared 10 months ago. Even more coincidentally, she also has three sons in her family. Jack thinks the killer's next target, possibly the Connors. But it's too late when they get here. The entire Connor family was killed, exactly the same as Thrun family was killed. But this time there seems a little accident. The killer shot Mrs. Connor twice before killing her. Also took a Christmas gift from his mother. It seems the killer did this to deprive the identity of the mother. But who is this charred body in fireplace?
I'd say Connor first. He'd been prepped to shoot his mother, not wash her sock.
Connor couldn't put his panic back in a bottle, so he got shot too.
Whoever shot him disowned him.
Two consecutive homicides. Make Will feel a bit anxious. He tried to compare the identity of two children. See if he can find some useful clues. At this time, the forensic brought a message. The police compared the live warheads of Connor and Trena. Found the warhead was extremely consistent with the three warheads in the main murder case a year ago. Data simply 13-year-old Lincoln killed his own mother. He has no violent tendencies and antisocial personality. Even Lincoln is a member of the Animal Protect Association. But such a loving big boy killed his own mother. And he was the leader of two murders cases. Then the police summarized the time and place of the three cases. Judging from activity track, the killer went south all the way to commit crimes continuously. And each case has a distance of 500 miles. Jack thinks just fine missing boy within this range can successfully catch the killer and solve the case. At this time Will suggests shorten the search scope. Cause most of controlled children belong to wealthy families. And no signs of abuse. And the reason for killing family members is cause they both suffer from Stockholm Syndrome. Stockholm Syndrome is when the victim is in a vulnerable situation. Some victims may develop a sense of dependence with the perpetrator. Even Will protect and assist the perpetrators in reverse. This symptom is also called as passive captive personality. The police then targeted a boy named Chris. Will tell Jack. These missing boys are all possessed by a woman. She plays the role of mother in this pseudo-family. And want to build a new family. First is to erase the existence of original family. Then Jack led his men to Chris's house and broke in. Coincidentally caught up with Mr. and Mrs. Chris entertaining the missing kids. Large number of FBI stepped forward, completely control the scene. And Chris pushes the fence, ran to a swimming pool. And the real murderer also came out of the warehouse.
Shoot him, Christopher.
Fortunately, the forensic saved Will with a shot in time, as the killer is brought to justice. This serial murder case has finally been solved. But in the near future, the emergence of a crime gives Will an inexplicable sense of fear in his heart.